In today's video, I am going to explain important muscle anatomy and joint structure for turnout of ballet. Turnout, what is that? Simply, it is hip external rotation position and external rotation movement. That is called turnout. Then, I'm going to explain which muscle you should focus and which muscle you should stretch. Okay, then the main muscles for turnout is these tiny muscles. There are 6 muscles. All these muscles together, it is called deep lateral rotator. Deep lateral rotator or deep lateral rotator for hip. When you want to do turnout, you need to do hip external rotation. This is freaking important because 60% out of 100% turnout happens in hip joint. That takes about 60% of whole movement. That is important, right? Thus, you need to be able to use these muscles properly. However, here's the problem. These muscles are so deep because it's literally deep lateral rotator. It's hard to feel where these muscles are. Why is that? Because there's huge muscle above deep lateral rotator. What is it? That is gluteus maximus. Indeed, gluteus maximus is huge muscle. Thus, it's hard to feel there are such tiny muscles deep to gluteus maximus. So, if you can use deep lateral rotator, if you can feel where deep lateral rotators are, it's going to be easy to do external rotation. Okay, again, turnout is about external rotation of hip. External rotation, it's like you twist hip joint outward. This is external rotation. This is turnout. Thus, it's important to be able to feel you are using deep lateral rotators. It's good if you know where that is. That is deep to gluteus maximus. At least now you know where it is. Then you can feel where it is. Then you can feel what kind of muscles you are using during lesson, right? Important thing, again, is you should be able to use deep lateral rotator for turnout because turnout is about external rotation. Plus, 60% out of whole turnout movement is accomplished in hip joint. That's so important. Now, this is about which muscles you should use. Then, I'm going to explain which muscle you should get more flexible for turnout. Okay, I was talking about that you should be able to use deep lateral rotator. You should be able to do external rotation of hip. That means if your internal rotation muscles are tight, that's going to be a problem. Internal rotation, that is kind of you twist hip inward. It is going to be a problem. Why? Because again, turnout is about external rotation of hip. You need good range of motion of external rotation. However, if your internal rotation muscles are tight, your hip is stabilized at internal rotation position. In result, you can't do external rotation. That's going to be a problem. What kind of muscles do internal rotation? First muscle is this one. This is tensor fascia latae. Tensor fascia latae is on anterior part and slightly lateral part of hip. And two more muscles, that's gluteus medius. Gluteus medius and minimus. Tensor fascia latae, gluteus medius and minimus. And few adductor muscles also can do internal rotation. Adductor muscles. Thus, if these muscles are tight, your hip is brought to internal rotation position. In result, it's hard to do external rotation, then you cannot do good turnout. That is about external rotation. I have to keep repeating. External rotation is essential for turnout. Okay? Then you should stretch these internal hip rotation muscles. You got it? You should be able to use external rotation muscles. Then you need good flexibility for internal rotation muscles. This is about muscle mechanics. And let me explain important joint structure for turnout. Okay, this is superior view. You are looking femur from above. This is right side femur. You see head of femur. Because you are looking lower extremity from superior view, you see patella right here. And this is the most inferior part of femur. Okay? Then let's see. Let's imagine there is horizontal level of knee. You know, this is like a knee joint line. Then this is neck of femur. Neck of femur and knee joint is not completely horizontal. You see that? There is angle between these two structures. In normal people, this angle is about 15 degrees. About 15 degrees. This is important. But congenitally, this angle varies. Some people get more angles, some people get less angles. If there's more angle, it's going to be problem. So it's going to be like this. Neck of femur goes more posterior. And this bony structure goes more posterior. This position is called anteversion. Anteversion. The bony structure goes more posterior. On the other hand, if this angle gets smaller and this bony structure goes more anterior, it's gonna be retroversion. Retroversion. Usually, anteversion people are hard to go external rotation because bony structure is originally around posterior. Then there's not much space for external rotation. Does it make sense? On the other hand, for retroversion people, it's going to be easy to go more external rotation because bony structure is about here. There's more space to go for external rotation. So usually, anteversion people are hard to go more for external rotation. So is there no help for anteversion people? Yes, there is. But you cannot change bony structure. That is congenital thing. You cannot change this angle of neck of femur. But you can change flexibility of muscle tissues. So you need more better flexibility for internal rotator. And you should have better coordination for deep lateral rotator. Again, you can't change bony structure, but you can change flexibility of muscle and you can focus more on how to use deep lateral rotators. You know, you should deal your game by what you have. You cannot deserve for bony structure. You should manage with what you have. So I hope this video gives a good idea to improve ballet performance. This information is not only for ballet. It's going to be good for other kind of dancers. It's going to be good for martial arts practitioners. This can be good for athletes. The hip movement is important for many kind of things. So I hope this video gives help for your performance. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button. comment, and subscribe. See you next video.